You're watching Tag TV.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, traditions, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization, keeping its age-old culture maintained. Today, the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Yeshi, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give a glimpse of our country's diversity. Being an agrarian society, India celebrates a number of harvest festivals that form an integral part of the country's cultural legacy, and over the centuries they have evolved in various forms. Onam, that marks the commemoration of Vamana, form of Lord Vishnu, is the biggest harvest festival in southern state of Kerala and is observed with much enthusiasm. Take a look.
Flowers filled the air with its fragrance and markets were bustling with people in Kerala as the state observed its 10-day-long annual harvest festival of Onam. Celebrated at the beginning of Chingam, the first month of the Malayalam calendar, the festival marks the annual homecoming of King Mahabali, who is believed to have come from the netherworld to check on his citizens. It is said that the state witnessed golden period under King. As the idea is to welcome the beloved King Mahabali, a traditional flower carpet named Pukkalam is placed in the doorway of every home. One of the oldest festivals of Kerala, Onam is regarded as a wonderful show of the state's rich cultural diversity.
Onam is our state festival, Kerala's one of the festival which people look forward to celebrate every year. And this happens this month of August, September. And this is very important for Kerala because it is actually a celebration of biodiversity. It's a celebration of flowers. It's a celebration of harvest. So it's also a harvest festival. So, in a sense, it's a celebration of, as I said, the biodiversity, celebration of richness of our culture also. And it's also important that it is beyond any caste or religion. So, it's a state's festival.
Onam is believed to have originated from Vamana Murthy Temple in Kochi's Srikakara area and then spread across the state. It is one of the few temples in India that are dedicated to Lord Vamana, the fifth incarnation of Lord Vishnu. Usually, the temple witnesses a huge crowd on the festival. However, since the last 2 years, the celebrations are kept a low-key affair due to the COVID-19 pandemic.
COVID government day, Devasam Board day, okay. COVID protocol, kritimai palichu kondu thanneyanu. Ee varsham nammal ivide thiruvulsam nadathi varunnathu. ഭക്തജനങ്ങളെല്ലാം കോവിഡ് മാനദണ്ഡങ്ങൾ പാലിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെയാണ് ദർശനം നടത്തി വരുന്നത്. ഈ വർഷം ക്ഷേത്രാചാര അനുഷ്ഠാന ക്ഷേത്രകലകൾ മാത്രം ഉൾപ്പെടുത്തിക്കൊണ്ടുള്ള ഒരു ലളിതമായ ചടങ്ങുകളോടുകൂടിയ തിരുവുത്സവമാണ് നമ്മൾ നടത്തിയത്. നിർഭാഗ്യവശാൽ തൃക്കാക്കരയപ്പൻ്റെ ഏറ്റവും പ്രിയപ്പെട്ട ഓണസദ്യ നടത്താൻ നമുക്ക് ഈ വർഷവും സാധിച്ചിട്ടില്ല. ആ ഒരു കാര്യം ഒഴിച്ചു നിർത്തിയാൽ ബാക്കിയെല്ലാം വളരെ ഭംഗിയായി തന്നെ പര്യവസാനിക്കുന്നതിനുള്ള ഒരു സാഹചര്യം ആണ് നിലവിലുള്ളത്.
Onam is also considered as the biggest shopping festival in urban areas such as Kochi and Trivandrum, as most of the shops give mega discounts during this time. It brings together a multitude of colors and flavors from across God's own country, and the celebrations reach their apex on Thiru Onam, which is the most important and auspicious day of the festival.
India is well known across the world for its unity and diversity, and this variety is implicit to Indian festivals as well. In Kanpur, an extra hue got added to the festivity of Raksha Bandhan, where people of two different faiths observed the occasion together. With this act, they not only celebrated the beautiful bond between brothers and sisters, but also fostered the long-practiced communal harmony in the country. Take a look. For the last many years, Kanpur city of Uttar Pradesh has been giving a new meaning to the Hindu festival of Raksha Bandhan. In Yashoda Nagar area of the city, two Muslim sisters have been tying rakhis on the wrist of their Hindu brothers to celebrate the occasion. This tradition has become a medium to strengthen the bond between the two communities and symbolize the fact that the bond shared by brothers and sisters is above any religion or caste.
ये मेरी मुस्लिम बहनें हैं, हम विगत कई वर्षों से इन बहनों से राखी बंधा रहे हैं और जो मेरे देश की संस्कृति है गंगा जमुनी तहजीब, इस पे हम लोग और आने वाली पीढ़ियों को भी संदेश देते हैं कि इसको कायम रखें। और लोग, हम लोगों में कोई ऐसा नहीं है कि हिंदू मुस्लिम इस तरीके का कुछ नहीं, जैसे हमारी बहनें हैं वैसे ये बहनें, हमको कभी महसूस ही नहीं हुआ, ये हमारा घर है, परिवार है हमारा, कभी ऐसा महसूस नहीं हुआ कि हमको ये हमारी मुस्लिम बहनें या हिंदू बहनें, कभी लगते नहीं बहन है, इसमें हिंदू मुस्लिम की क्या बात है।
In India, Raksha Bandhan is celebrated for ages and has many tales associated with it. One such tale which is symbolic to this beautiful brother-sister bond between Hindus and Muslims is that of Maharani Karnavati, the Queen of Chittor and Emperor Humayun. It is said that when Chittor, the Rajput kingdom in Rajasthan, was threatened by Bahadur Shah of Mewar, the Queen Karnavati sent Rakhi to Humayun, the Mughal Emperor of Delhi. Humayun, who was aware of the significance of Rakhi in the Hindu community, willingly accepted it and promised to protect her. Today, the same tradition is being taken forward by a locality in Kanpur. And it's not just the Raksha Bandhan that is celebrated together by these Hindu and Muslim people, but other occasions too are observed with same enthusiasm.
काफी टाइम हो गया है और हम लोगों को बहुत अच्छा लगता है अपने भाइयों को राखी बांधते हुए, सब अपना सा लगता है, ऐसा लगता है कि हमारे सगे भाई हैं।
Raksha Bandhan is a prominent festival celebrated all across India. Sisters tie sacred thread on their brother's wrist and wish for their well-being and prosperity, who in return take a pledge for their security in every situation thrown at them. Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Delhi government recently inaugurated a smog tower to tackle the pollution that engulfs the national capital every year during the months of October, making the air unbreathable for residents. The tower, which is about 24 meters high, has been installed at Connaught Place market area of the city.
Pollution se ladne ke liye, apni hawa saaf karne ke liye, aaj Delhi mein desh ka sabse pehla smog tower lagaya ja raha hai.
Smog towers are structures designed as large-scale air purifiers to reduce air pollution particles, the prototype for which was built in 2017 by Dutch artist Dan Roosgaard in Beijing. An 86-year-old engineer from Maharashtra's Pune city is grabbing eyeballs with his handmade dolls collection that he began well over the age of 50 years. His dolls look like performing Indian classical dance forms, going shopping with their children, being ninja warriors and simply tying wedding knots.
At the age of 55, I decided now all the family responsibilities are over. So I will do whatever I want to do all my lifetime, which I have been reading in the Reader Digest for quite some time. In the United States, people, doctor becomes farmers, farmers become doctors and all that. I say, why I can't become an artist or a sculptor?
He specifically loves making Japanese dolls as he is specially drawn to their culture. When asked about the number of dolls in his collection, he just smiled and said he just keeps making them. He can't quote any number as he himself never counted. A non-governmental organization is distributing free groceries to the people of villages in India's eastern Bihar state who are 100% vaccinated against the coronavirus. Members of a Canada-based NGO, Eyes of Compassion Relief Organization,
distributed free grocery packets to villagers in the state's Gaya district and said they wanted to support the Indian government's vaccination campaign against COVID-19.
जो गांव पूरा वैक्सीन ले चुका है या जो गांव ले रहे हैं वैक्सीन, वहां पर हम जागरूक कर रहे हैं और साथ में जो राशन सामग्री देकर उपहार के रूप में दे रहे हैं। अभी राशन सामग्री में बहुत से सामान मिल रहा है, साथ में हैंडपम्प भी दे रहे हैं और ये भारत सरकार का पहल है कि जितना जल्दी जल्दी वैक्सीन ले ताकि कोरोना को हम जल्द से जल्द मुक्त कर सकें।
इंडिया हैज अंडरटेकन वन ऑफ द वर्ल्ड्स लार्जेस्ट कोविड-19 वैक्सीनेशन ड्राइव्स एंड हैज सो फार एडमिनिस्टर्ड ओवर 554 मिलियन डोजेस, giving at least one dose to about 46% of its estimated 944 million adults.
Sufism has played an important role in teaching citizens values like humanity and brotherhood around the world. It is through the dargahs of these Sufi saints that bring together people of different faiths and give out loud messages of humanity and togetherness. So today we will take a look at one such dargah in Hyderabad city of Telangana, which has been bringing together citizens of different communities under a single roof. Take a look.
Situated in Hyderabad city of Telangana, the shrine of Hazrat Sayyid Ahmed Barepa has served as a cynosure of communal harmony for generations. It is thronged by a large number of devotees every day from across the nation, irrespective of their religion. Regarded as one of the greatest Sufi saints, Hazrat Sayyid Ahmed Barepa throughout his life spread the message of Sufism and peace.
बस अमन और दीन को फैलाना आपका काम था। यहाँ पर तो देखिए हर किस्म के लोग आते, हर मज़हब के लोग आते। यहाँ पर हमारे बस्ती में भी हिंदू भाई है बहुत सारे, बराबर वो यकीदे से जो है सो जुमेरात के दिन तो बराबर पक्का यहाँ पर आते हैं हाजिरी देने के लिए, जो जो अपनी दुआएं हैं वो लेके आते हैं बराबर।
Coming from far and wide, the devotees attend the prayers to seek the blessings of the holy saint. It is believed that saint fulfills the wishes of all and nobody returns empty-handed from his dargah.
Yaqeeda to bahut hai, jo cheez maange wo cheez har puri hoti hai khwahish. To daily aata hu main. Aise to mere jaise bhojan hai daily aate hai. रात में 1 बजे भी आते, 2 बजे भी आते, यकीरमंद लोग बहुत से बड़े बड़े लोग भी आते हैं, बिल्डर्स से लेके पॉलिटिशन से लेके हर चीज़ हर जना आता है यहाँ पर, सियासत का हर आदमी आता है, अदब और आदाब से आकर यहाँ पर ख़दम बोसी करके जाता है।
Since ages, the Sufi saints like Hazrat Sayyid Ahmed Barepa have been propagating the message of spiritualism and harmony in our country, and their teachings are still playing a significant role in strengthening the threat of secularism.
Next, we take you to Jammu and Kashmir, where a 20-year-old Samania Bhatt has become the talk of the town. Having achieved a feat of the youngest radio jockey of North Kashmir, but has been inspiring thousands of youngsters to chase their dreams.
Assalamu alaikum Kashmir. Aapne tune kiya hai aapka apna favorite radio station Radio Chennai Dil Ki Dhadkan.
Every day from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m., Samania Bhatt is ready for Halla Bol. With her soulful voice and innovative messages, she has been gratifying people of North Kashmir ever since she joined Radio Chinar 90.4 FM. The studio of this radio station is situated at Magzab area of Baramulla's Sopor town. In February, when it invited applications for radio jockeys, Samania decided to grab the opportunity. But getting selected was not a cakewalk for her. She had to face tough competition and several rounds of interviews before finally getting selected as RJ. Out of 250 candidates, 4 got selected and she was the only female among them. Her achievements has not just made her the youngest RJ of Radio Chinar, but of the entire North Kashmir.
when I got to heard that, I heard that Radio Chinar is going to have its first radio station in North Kashmir. So I thought that एक ट्राई देते हैं बट आई नेवर हैड अ प्लान ऑफ माइंड सच ऐसा कि मैं कभी रेडियो जॉकी बनूंगी या रेडियो स्टेशन में काम करूंगी तो मैंने सोचा कि अपॉर्चुनिटी है मुझे ट्राई करनी चाहिए एंड वहां पे ऑडिशन हुआ एंड वी वर अराउंड 250 पार्टिसिपेंट्स एंड उसमें हम चार सेलेक्ट हुए एंड आई एम द ओनली फीमेल
Hailing from the main town Baramulla, Samanya has recently completed her bachelor's in journalism and mass communication from the district's government degree college. She was passionate about journalism since childhood. During her college days, she even worked with Kashmir Dispatch, where she got a chance to know about the ground realities. Ever since she got selected for Radio Chinar, there has been no looking back for her. From Bollywood celebs to local artists, people from different backgrounds have registered their presence on her show. While talking about her parents who have been the wind beneath her wings, Samanya says that they have always encouraged her to achieve her dreams.
Radio Chinar different is hisab se hai ki hum sirf entertainment hi nahi balki hum इन्फोटेनमेंट भी साथ ही साथ प्रोवाइड करते हैं लोगों को एंड जो कि बहुत ही ज़्यादा डिफरेंट बनाता है रेडियो चुनार को एंड रिसेंटली हमने स्टार्ट किया हम आउटडोर ब्रॉडकास्टिंग भी करते हैं हमने रिसेंटली कुछ सेलिब्रिटीज़ के इंटरव्यूज़ भी मैंने किए जैसे विकी कौशल का मैंने आउटडोर किया है इंटरव्यू सोनल चौहान का किया है एंड यहाँ पर हमेशा हमारी ट्राई रहती है कि हम यूथ के साथ कनेक्ट कर पाए एंड रेडियो चुनार का एंड हमारा यही मेन पर्पस है टू कनेक्ट विथ यूथ और जितना हो सके हम यूथ से कनेक्ट करें और जाने उनको एक प्लेटफॉर्म दें
Samanya's colleagues are also very proud of her and believe that she's an inspiration for the youth.
She is one of the youngest team members over here aur jab hum Sopor ki baat karte hain North Kashmir district Baramulla ki baat karte hain she is first female RJ plus she is youngest and being a station head I feel very proud ke bahut sare media houses ne Samanya ki story cover ki hai aur bahut acha lag raha hai because aisi ladkiyan jab aage aati hain aur kaam karti hain with a professional mindset to baki log bhi inspire hote hain
though Samanya never intended to be an RJ her hard work and dedication has definitely enabled her to pull off the coup
Next, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section, World in Focus. Japanese company Rinnai is famous for gas stoves and water heaters. Recently, it has developed thermal energy tools and machinery. Over a century-old company continues to produce advanced devices to improve social life. In 1918, the founder of Rinnai, Hidejiro Naito, invented an oil-gas cooking stove. It aims to realize comfortable daily life based on the principles of contribution to society. The latest micro and ultra-fine bubble technology of Rinnai provides a comfortable bath unit. The bubble has three categories, which are milli, micro and ultra-fine. The process by which a fine bubble is created is made possible by Rinnai's accumulator technology.
今回特にやはりこだわった製品開発でこだわったのはこちら循環金具になっておりまして、お湯を吐き出す口になるわけなんですけれども、こちらノズル形状試作をですね30個以上も繰り返しながら開発に至りましたけれども、このノズル開発が非常にこの細かい泡を生み出す部分で、キーデバイスになっておりまして、圧倒的な白く濁るといった演出に一役買っております。
Micro and ultra-fine bubbles technology is beneficial for health. It penetrates the pores of the skin and keeps the skin hydrated. The bubbles even help to remove dirt from skin. Rinnai is also conducting a clinical trial in nursing homes for the elderly to further improve the functioning of the product. Rinnai policy is to raise quality daily life by introducing new advanced products for over the next 100 years. The second edition of the Amman International Film Festival recently kicked off in Jordan's Amman, featuring a total of 51 films from 26 countries. The festival focuses on first-time directors with the aim of shedding light on young talent in the region.
سعداء ويشرفنا حضور حوالي ما يزيد على 65 ضيف من الخارج من مخرجين الأفلام من مهنيين من خبراء سينمائيين طبعا هذا بيثري البرنامج رح يكون في نقاشات بعد عروض الأفلام كما أنه عم بيكون في مشاركات لهم في إطار أيام عمان لصناع الأفلام التي تستهدف المهنيين في هذا المجال.
Running until August 31st, the festival includes masterclasses, panel discussions and pitching sessions to support aspiring filmmakers. The festival is held under the umbrella of the Royal Film Commission and offers screenings in several locations around the kingdom, one of which is a drive-in theatre, which proved to be popular last year when the festival was held outdoors due to COVID-19 restrictions. Some parts of northern Japan witnesses severe winter weather and unprecedented snowfall. Located in Nagano Prefecture, Liama City has cleverly transformed those pesky heavy snows into Snow Dome or Kamakura Restaurant. Visitors come here from across Japan to enjoy unique experiences and taste traditional dishes in the annual village of Snow Dome. The idea started 22 years ago, when people used to shovel snow off-road and pile it into empty field. To keep the kids entertained, they turn it into Snow Dome. Then the idea expanded to an annual festival to attract visitors.
で、その風船のところにその除雪機で水を飛ばして人間が踏み固めて作り出した。それでだいたいね、7、8年で周りで指飛ばして踏み固めて、最初はこういうね、もっと三角形、斜めのやつだったらしいんですけども、写真見るとね、で、それを
These domes were later converted into restaurants. The cost of renting single dome is about $30 for an hour and a half. It includes a local delicious meal. In this nearby kitchen, women from the town prepare local dishes using mushrooms, carrots, miso soup and meat. Then it is taken by the staff to each snow dome. Project organizers are keen to present everything with local flavor so that visitors can enjoy taste of home dishes. Visitors can also stay until evening to enjoy dinner amid candle lighting around the snow dome. Apart from this, there are lanterns to complete the unique tourism experience in this beautiful Japanese town. That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. I'm your host Yeshi and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.